Good morning, babies, and welcome to Simply Stacy, where the joy of the Lord is our strength. Well, babies, I'm kind of saddened this morning because a couple churches got burnt down in Delaware. And I tell you, it's a sad case, and people act like this stuff is new. But I want to talk about the big R today, racism. Now, people of God, we should not be giving in to all the stuff that's going on in this culture when it comes to racism. Racism is just not subject to America. It's all over the world, in every arena, in every situation. You know, Galatians 3 and 28 say, there is neither Greek nor Jew, slave nor free, male nor female for you. You know, in every situation, there is division. It is a trick of the enemy. You know, men think they better than women. We got a power struggle with that, issues with that. That's division. You know, because of the color of your skin, there's division. You know, because of your financial status, there's division. You know, just so much division. But when it comes to God, God died on the cross for all of us. All men. He created all men equal. It's not just the black race, the white race, you know, Chinese race, Indian race. It's neither Greek nor Jew, slave nor free. You know, we're all the human race, one race. It's just like a crayon box. You got different crayons in there, but it's all one crayon box. They're all the same. They just different colors in the crayon box. You know, we're all judged throughout life by what you look like, you know, what color your hair is, what size and shape you are. All this stuff brings divisions. But in God, as people of God, we need to always go back to the Bible, what it says on these situations. God is not for division. He is for love, unity, peace. And if you're not operating out of that spirit, you're in the wrong spirit, people of God. Don't look at your color. Look at God. Go in this word and seek God. It's a trick of the enemy to get you off of people being saved and bringing unity in the body of Christ. You know, a lot of churches adopt the worldly culture instead of setting the culture from the word of God. We should not be following the culture out here in the world. We need to be setting the tone from the word of God and what God says on these situations. Well, babies, the enemy has figured out many ways to bring division. And I've always said all through life is divide and conquer. He bring division, he conquer you. He got you. You don't want to be divided when it comes to God. We need to have a togetherness, a uniform stance. I don't care what color you are. We are of God, the body of Christ, redeemed, saved. We're supposed to be changed by the renewing of our mind. We are family. More than our own families, we're families when you're in the blood of God. Because we die today or tomorrow, we won't see our family if they're not saved. We're going to be going with our blood family in the body of Christ that has the same DNA as our Father, which is God in heaven. Babies, we need to always remember as people of God that our final authority is the Word. And what does God say in the Word about every situation? Racism is nothing new. It was dealt with all through the Bible. But you have to walk in love. No change is going to come until you walk in love. And stop looking at people because of their skin color, for their financial status, because they're male or female. It does not make no difference. We're all the children of God. He created us all. Love ye one another as he has loved us. You know, I tell you, God is just so good. And that's John 13 and 34. Love ye one another as God has loved us. Man, I tell you, it's just a sad thing. And don't model ungodly men's attitudes towards ungodly situations. Model after God. Model after God and what he wants you to do in these situations. That's every situation. You know, I had a conversation with someone yesterday, and we was talking about Steve Harvey's book. You know, when it comes to women of God, we can't listen at that. You know, ain't no 30-day rule when it comes to sex. God says no sex until you're married. Model after God. Go on your word and see what God says in these situations, because that is what is putting you in ungodly situations. And then you curse yourself with a curse because you're on the enemy's territory. You open your gates up and open your life up to demonic spirits. And all types of things is happening to you because you're not standing on God's words and principles. You're walking in ungodly men's attitudes, mindsets, and information. So, babies, I just want to let you know today that go to God. God laid his life down for all men. 1 John 2:2. He laid his life down for all men. He didn't say, oh, I'm just going to do it for this color. I'm just going to do it for that color. But the enemy is about division. Don't allow him to bring division in your families. You see it with your siblings. You see it with your children. You know, people just going around this earth thinking they're better than one another. We all have same basic needs. Food, shelter, clothing. And we want life. And God came and died that we might have life and life more abundantly. But babies, I just want to let you know today that listen at God, get his word, know how he stands on these situations, and don't go with ungodly men and follow what they're saying on these situations. The body of Christ need to come together, and the ones that's walking in the spirit is going to walk by love and have peace and a sound mind. You're not going to be tossed to and fro with every decision that the world makes. I don't care what the president say. What does God say? He's our final authority. I don't care what your pastor say. If he's not walking in the spirit, God is the final authority. If somebody is talking to you and it's not bringing peace and love and a sound mind in that situation, it is not of God. I don't care who it is that it is speaking through. You got to make sure that they're being used by God and they're speaking what God speaks. Are they bearing the fruit of the Spirit? Well, babies, I love you, and so does God. But we need to stop following behind ungodly men and remember who the final authority is. It's our God, who we say we love, who we say we submitted our life to. It is God. He is the final authority on every decision that we make in our life. Well, babies, I love you, and so does God. Smooches, and be blessed. Pray, saints, pray. Pray, fast,